Welcome back, students. By now, you should have completed the sampling portion of the lab and filled out your OTU catalog, your sampling data sheets, and your diversity calculation table. Now we will move on to how to complete your homework. You've had to take 8 samples of the habitat that you studied, but based on those samples, do you think that you have found all the OTUs or species present? What if you sampled in a habitat like this one? Suppose you sampled an area and found 10 individuals and 2 different OTUs. Then you increased your sample to 100 individuals and found 20 OTUs. If you scaled up to 1,000 individuals, would you get 200 OTUs? You might be thinking to yourself that maybe there is a relationship between the number of organisms you study and the number of species or OTUs that you find. We can illustrate and better understand the relationship with a rarefaction plot. Let's start with an example of a rarefaction plot. This plot is from a study of small mammals in a forest in French Guiana. The x-axis shows the combined numbers of individual small mammals as more samples are taken. The y-axis shows the combined numbers of small mammal species as more individuals are collected. Notice that as more individuals are collected, more species are found. Does it look like this will continue indefinitely? Based on the shape of the curve, approximately how many mammal individuals should be collected to include all the mammal species in the study area? What do you think the curve would look like if there were still more species to find? Now let's go ahead and look at how to make a rarefaction plot. So for your own rarefaction plot, you'll be using the data you collected to do your diversity index calculation, as well as the data ordering table. What I have here is just an example I made, which should be quite close to the data you already have. Let's briefly go over the layout. So we have my community up here, which is just my backyard, and across in columns are my species or OTUs. You might have these ordered as red flower, curly leaf, etc., but for this example, we'll keep it basic with species 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Over here as my rows, I have my sample numbers, and on the far right over here, a total number of specimens or number of individuals from each sample. So let's talk about the samples for a moment. This table lays out all of the information out very nicely, but we need that data in a format that we can graph. So I'm going to show you how to transform your data with the help of a second table. For efficiency, this table is already filled, but don't worry, I'm going to go over how to get these numbers right now. So going back to our raw data table, we see that for sample 1, we have 2 different species and an individual for each. So in the table to the right, we've put 2 for the number of species and 2 for the number of individuals. Then for sample 2, we found 3 species and a total of 4 individuals. But wait, why does it say 4 for the number of species when we found 3? Well, if you look at species number 2, we've already counted that from sample 1. So we're not going to count it again. Instead, we'll have 2 species from sample 2, and 2 plus the first 2 species we found in sample 1 would give you a sum of 4 for the number of species. For total number of individuals, we found 4 individuals in sample 2. We add that to the 2 we found in sample 1, and we get a sum of 6. You can almost think of the way we are ordering samples in a chronological sense. So if we do number 3, you can interpret it as, by sample 3, how many species and how many individuals have we collected? So let's go ahead and just do sample 3 to make sure you understand how this works. So if we look at the raw data again, we found 2 species in sample 3, species 1 and species 5, but since we've already added species 1 to our cumulative count, we won't count that one, which means we only found 1 new species. So we'll take that, add that to our previous 4 species, and we get 5. And then we found 2 individuals in sample 3. We add that to the previous 6 that we got. And so for sample 3 in the table on the right, we have a sum of 8 as a total number of individuals. And then we did that for the rest of the data here. Now that we have your data transformed, we can graph it. So we have our graph here with number of individuals on the x-axis, and on the y-axis we have the number of species. We're going to just plug in the points that we have based on the table. So for sample one, we've got 2 for the number of species and 2 for the number of individuals. That'll go here. And then we move on to the next one, which has 4 for the total number of species and 6 for the number of individuals. So that will go here. So we'll go ahead and keep plotting all 8 samples. And now that we've put in all 8 samples, we can see that there is a trend here to these samples, and we could draw in a general trend line. And voila, a rarefaction curve. You really tend to see 2 different types of trends to the data. Either your curve will look like this, or it will look more like this. It just depends on your data. And that's how you do a rarefaction plot. You can review this video again as needed, and if you have any questions, please contact your TA. Thank you for watching!